Hello everyone. With you, Krivuli Andrew Charlie. And in this video, we talk about the modify roots feature in Ornatrix for Cinema 4D, which includes different modes for modifying guides. Just a reminder that you can become a channel sponsor and get a voiceover in another language, a collection of my references and a 100% discount on all my assets. Just click the join button to do it. Also, if this is your first time on this channel, and you want to know what it's about, as well as support me, watch the channel's trailer and read all the information in the attached commentary. And please, don't forget to like and subscribe. I would be very grateful for that. Now, let's go to watch this episode. So, if we choose the rotate tool, then you have to turn off the modify roots option, then the rotation will work as necessary. If we choose move with this mode, it works a little differently. If you turn on modify roots again, the guide movement will work. The same works with the scale tool. If we want standard scaling, we have to turn off modify roots. And that's all I wanted to show in this video. If you liked this video, don't forget to write about it in the comments, put a like and subscribe to the channel. To be continued. See you soon. Peace, everybody. If this is your first time on this channel, then here, you can learn all the tricks and secrets of 3D grooming in Ornatrix. Also, get your questions answered and get inspired by references from the games. Subscribe and write in the comments how long you do 3D and why you chose this field. What influenced this? If you like what I do, I would be very grateful for any donation to Donatello at the link in the description and channel header, buying my models on CG Trader or ArtStation, as well as the purchase of any of the plugins at the links in the attached commentary. What's in it for you? It's very simple. If enough money is collected per month, I will be able to devote my full time to creating lessons for you, not 3 hours a day. Which, as you have already noticed, not enough for the first release of new episodes. Also, don't forget to check out the YouTube community, as I share there all kinds of news, uploading answers to questions, talking about the time spent time on lessons, and so on. And, of course, don't forget about my Instagram, where I upload all my work and work in progress.